reusable, don't forget. Final 3 minutes. The nice thing about it, Rochelle, is that anybody can do this.
Anybody
can do
this.
It's not complicated.
It's really easy to use. Once you have it on your kitchen counter and you start using it for one or two things, you start thinking of every different way you can use it. For instance, guacamole. We cut this avocado yesterday. We made the guacamole yesterday. And look at the difference here in the color.
Oh,
I just want you
gosh.
To see that. I mean, I feel like with avocado, it really shows what air does to food the best, because I feel like all you have to do is look at an avocado and it changes color. But these were made at the same time. And look at how green and fresh this is, and look at how this has already started to turn color. This is what air is doing to your food. It's really making it, you know, it's not gonna last as long. It's gonna start to degrade.
Yeah.
And you can tell that this is vacuum sealed because the little dimple is indicated right here. So you know all the air has been removed. But even just look at the bag and the avocado. So it looks, say you only want to use half of an avocado and you want to save the rest for later. These are expensive. They can be $1, $2 a piece. And then so if you're cutting it in half and using only half, you don't want to throw away a half. That's 50 cents every time, you know, you're cutting your avocados.
It adds up.
It really does add up. So this was cut yesterday. It's still green. It's still fresh. It still looks delicious. You know, I still want to put this on my sandwiches or make some new guacamole with this. And so really it's going to save you time and save you money.
And then our final two demonstrations here, because if you just buy it for these alone, it's worth it.
The pantry. So we talked about meats and we talked about your fresh fruits and vegetables, even items in your pantry. So we're getting into fall and the holidays, and how many times do you get into baking and you only need a quarter of a cup or a couple teaspoons? You can put your brown sugar in here. It's not going to get hard and crusty. It's going to remain nice and soft because we've removed the air from it, so it's going to stay fresh longer. Things like your pastries and breads, if you're buying bread, even a loaf of sandwich bread, you know, that first slice is always delicious. The last slice always usually has a little piece of mold on it.
Sure.
Personally, in my house, carbs don't last this long. You know, they go within a day. But if you're buying in bulk, if you're buying muffins in bulk because you have family visiting and you want to save some, you can definitely do that. Deli meats. This is what really got me into my food saver, saving deli meats. If you ever get your sandwich meat and it starts to get that sliminess after